Pastor, 46 years ago, 47 years ago, Pastor Lud Golz came in and started this church. And so I've asked Lud to come up here and to just give a few things about the heartbeat of the church 46, 47 years ago when he started it, as well as give a quick update for himself as well.
Thank you. It's good to be here. I'm sorry I had to leave the way I did 7 months ago. It was totally out of my control. God was in charge. Sometimes I wondered whether that was happening. But the word that came to my mind when I thought of sharing from my own experience as well as reflecting on the start of the church is survival. When I was in the hospital, I didn't know whether I would survive 7 months ago. And then when I was released from the hospital, I didn't know where I was going to go because our house was being sold and it was empty. So I couldn't go home. I couldn't travel yet. And so I hung out in a hotel for 8 days. And people asked me, how are you doing? And my response was surviving. At the beginning of the church, a lot of us felt survival was something that we couldn't guarantee. This was a new start. In 3 weeks, those who wanted to start the church got together and they asked me if I would come and speak. They had asked me if I'd consider being the pastor, and I turned them down. But we signed for a house, and I had a mortgage that I needed to pay, and my kids were going back to school. And after I spoke that Sunday, they asked me again, and I figured I better take the offer because I need a job. And God has worked amazing things, actually, in the 47 years since that happened. There were times in the opening period of time, that was in 76, when we had an energy crisis, and we didn't know whether where we were meeting was going to be open or not. There were a lot of uncertainties, but life is full of uncertainties, and the disciples were no different. Peter, was this brave crusader wanting to die for Jesus, and then he backed down when being identified by a young lady when Jesus was being examined. And it wasn't real clear in his mind that this venture was going to work. In fact, during the 40 days that Jesus spent with them, he went to Peter one time after a fishing expedition that Peter was on, and he said over breakfast, "Peter, do you really love me?" And Peter, feeling not too strong in his convictions now after his failure, said, "You know, Lord, that I love you." And Jesus asked him a second time, "Do you really love me?" And Peter said, "Lord, you know that I love you." And the third time Jesus asked him, he said, "Do you love me?" And I was thinking, he was surviving at that time. His dreams had been shattered. He had failed. And the challenge that Jesus was giving them during those 40 days was overwhelming. But they did obey. They did what they felt God wanted them to do. And in God's time, Pentecost happened and Jerusalem was turned upside down. Well, Chagrin Falls hasn't been turned upside down, but things have happened in those 47 years and God has done some amazing things. The elders were not elders at the time. They were just lay leaders who were willing to roll up their sleeves. We met once a week, actually. and then met on Sundays, and we met in small groups. We called them mini churches, and the leaders led the small groups, and those became critical dynamics in the early development of the church. And over the years, I believe that the small groups have been at the heart of the development of the church. It's where people begin to be more authentic and sharing and opening their hearts. And God has been good in giving the word from the pulpit, interacting with each other in small groups, and God has done some amazing things through this church, and I'm glad to have been a part of it. And I feel as though I'm still a part of it, because I wouldn't be here if I didn't have a group of people like you and many others praying. I've gotten through the loss of my wife, which I sense deeply. But God is the same, and she's in heaven, and I'm glad about that. 63 years she put up with me, and she's being rewarded now. But even though she's gone, the Holy Spirit is still present, and we need to rely upon Him. I'm in a whole new environment now, all senior citizens. And I'm one of the older ones, but fortunately I'm still able to function well, so I can interact with them, relate to them, and try to minister to them. I thank you for your prayers, for your understanding. I did want to come back and in person tell you that I love you. I appreciate your love for us, for me. And I would ask you to keep praying. The radio ministry still goes forward. This year, it's being broadcast in Chinese as well. And there's talk now of producing it in Portuguese for Brazil. So it's possible that I am being ministering to more people right now than I have at any point in my life, which is kind of amazing. When you think of it, but with God, all things are possible. So that's how our church started, made up of people who are imperfect, but who tried to obey God, and God was faithful to us far beyond our expectations. I believe the first message I preached was on the importance of love. And I think I talked from the book of Revelation, the church at Ephesus. They were doing great. But when Jesus looked at their hearts, he said, there's something I need to remind you of. The greatest quality of life that is to be manifest in the life of the church is love. And you've left your first love. You're doing all kinds of things great, but if the message of love is not thriving in your midst, the candlestick of your witness will be taken away from you. So my challenge to you is keep doing what you did early on in the life of the church. Keep doing what you have done for me and my family, praying for us, manifesting your love. And I trust that God will enable you to be, in a very real sense, baptized in the love of Christ, manifesting it, because by this all men will know that you are my disciples. You have love for one another. Take it, Joe.
Thank you. Thank you for your faithfulness, what you've meant to the church, what you mean to us, what you mean to... I want to thank you just here in front of everybody as a younger pastor to an experienced pastor who has many, many years. We learn so much. We've said this many, many times that we stand on the shoulders of giants that have gone before us, and Lud is absolutely one of those guys. And I appreciate your ministry and all that you've done. So, thank you.